like S10 pickup. 3.9 APR for 20 months, 4.9 for 60 months. Get over to Christensen Chevrolet right away and point ship at Indianapolis Boulevard in Island.
And this is Mike Bush in the WGOB newsroom. It's my pleasure to announce that the Bulls won tonight very decisively by 37 points over Toronto, 123-86. Now back out to Steve and Dave at East Chicago.
All righty, so the Bulls got 6 hours since the All-Star break. And Carlton Baker opens up the fourth quarter for the hang shot to the dotted line for a Cardinals score. They're up by 10. Now a Powell steal ahead to Jefferson. For Mitchell Tarver, a fingertip roll for the score. AC Central off the break with two quick baskets to open up the fourth quarter and to push the lead back out to 12. Merrillville has been as close as 6 after halftime, but no closer. Now a ball thrown away. Wilson again, a wraparound pass intended for Underwood. That one in. Mustard on it. And out of bounds it goes.
And that's the 22nd turnover so far here in the ballgame for Merrillville. And that's just that constant pressure by EC Central causes a lot of these turnovers.
Well, the first 45 seconds of the fourth quarter could end up being the ballgame. Trammell Powell lost it on the dribble, go right to Marcus Jefferson. Cardinals lead it by a dozen after Merrillville had cut it down to 6 and then 8. Powell top of the ring, wrapped for Ezell Moore, Mitchell Tarver in the far corner, now back out to Moore. Tried to come around the screen, but Randolph fought through it nicely. They drop it on the low block, Baker against the triple team, back out to Moore, and Randolph plays good!
Team foul.
In a team really close to getting into the bonus, Merrillville Myers with a couple of big three-point baskets. James Borum is back in his run along with Eugene Wilson. Frazier breaks the press. Dish one off for Carlton Baker on the inside. Lost it, but he covers it down. It's a foul. Frazier with a two-handed jump. He's got 14. The push is easy. Sends the lead back out to 16. It's 56-41. Midway through the fourth. Here's Wilson. Oh, and there again, you see what kind of quickness it is. Chicago Central brings you defensively. Zucampo Powell just got a hand of the passing lane. Seemed to come out of nowhere to break up the Eugene Wilson pass and out of bounds. Pirates inbounded. Quentin Allen breaks it to Davis along the near sideline. He's working on Brooks, who's over playing the right. Davis to the baseline. Pull up for 12, got it. As if to say, don't overplay me, away from the basket. Back up the Cardinals, jumps. Pass broken up and stolen away by Davis. Trying to go behind the back to rebound in trouble. And was fortunate to get away with that move. Allen into the forecourt for him. Baseline Jay from 10. Knocks it down. James Borum with a baseline jumper. And just like that, the Pirates trying to strike back. They're down 11, 56-45. Jefferson on the high dribble for the Central Cardinals. Zucampo Powell deep in the near corner. Back to Jefferson. Shovels a pass ahead to Keon Frazier, who works in between the circles. Tries to come around the screen, never develops. A Powell drives baseline, leaves it off Frazier, went in for a dunk and missed it. Rebound out the ball. 3-on-2 back on the Pirates. Wilson flying through the left hand and got it. The layup high off the glass. For Eugene Wilson, he's got 9. Cardinals back quickly. Wood bounces for Jefferson along the near baseline. It was cut off by Davis and lost it out high. It's a 9-point basketball game. EC Central on top with the basketball. And the Cardinals want a timeout.
20 seconds.
2:27 to go in the basketball game. EC Central 56, Merrillville 47. And Dave, a game of runs in the second half.
Well, Merrillville's shooting is fantastic here in the fourth quarter. From inside the arc so far, they're 5-for-5. From outside the arc, 1-for-2. East Chicago just missed the dunk by Baker, so they're 4-for-5 shooting inside the arc. And uncharacteristically, they have made their 2 3-point shots here in the fourth quarter. So both teams shooting very well, but EC still up by 9, which is 2:27 to go in the ballgame.
Well, clearly a very big possession for EC Central. They're slow to get out of the timeout. The official lays the basketball down, the count is on. Oh, and a whistle of foul against James Borum. Merrillville was just that close to getting the 5-second call on EC Central. Instead, Borum put the hands to Keon Frazier. Still one more foul to give for the Merrillville Pirates before EC Central goes into the bonus. Second on Borum, fifth on the team. Lean down again. Here's Frazier, spins around Borum, goes baseline, runners off the mark, rebounds, fouling up and out of bounds, last touch by the Cardinals, and the ball goes over to Merrillville. 2:17 to go in regulation. Scott Underwood quickly to the scorer's table, an offense for defense switch, and Jim East brings his three-point bomber back into the ballgame in the place of Eugene Wilson. Excuse me, Quentin Allen out of the ballgame. So it's Borum and Underwood out there with Wilson, Fedak, and Argenta against the Cardinal press. Borum brought it across the timeline. Contact and a foul on Ezell Moore. And Jimmy holds up one finger as if to indicate the first team foul called against the Central Cardinals in the second half.
And that brought the old Bronx cheer from the Merrillville fans that are here, because that was the first team foul. And it came at the 2:11 mark of the fourth quarter.
Foul was called on Ezell Moore, his first team's first. And Underwood, to put the ball in play in front of the scorer's table on the far side. Looking, gets it into Argenta. To Fedak in the high post to Underwood. One dribble brings it near side. Wilson at the hash mark, comes around the screen. Now backs it on out. We're down to the final 2 minutes of the fourth quarter. Powell reaches in, taps the label. Wilson recovers. Drives down for Argenta on the baseline. Six-footer is in and out. Baker the rebound. Ahead to Powell. One-hand pass to Wilson the lane. Back to Baker. Goes up with the kept shot. And Carlton Baker will go to the free throw line and shoot two.
Well, the Cardinals got that one down really, really quick. Just the quickness and speed, and there's no substitute for it. And now Baker will be at the line to shoot the two as the team leads by 9, 56-47, with 1:48 to go here in the fourth quarter.
Third foul on the freshman, James Borum, and the sixth on the team. So the Cardinals in the bonus the rest of the way. Baker's free throw up, good. song, it'd come out smelling like a rose. We're up by a dozen. 59-47. Pirates in the fulcrum, but now just a minute and a half to go. Now pass broken up. Goes ahead to Frazier, ahead of the pack, rides to the basket, fingertips on gold. Baker to follow. The putback is good. Cut Baker with 17. And whoever Hope Merrillville had has likely been stuffed out. Burrow dribbled it off his foot but recovers. Now he's got to find some help. Bounces for Eugene Wilson at the hash mark near side. We're down to the final 1 minute of play in the fourth quarter. Wilson off the crossover, drives to the dotted line, lost it, go to the basket. Back comes Woods, 3-on-2. Chris Woods behind the back, contact, and an offensive foul. And give James Borup the credit, the freshman, at 5'9 and 135, standing in the way of a runaway train. Took the charge on Chris Woods, second team foul on EC Central. Ball goes back over to Merrillville. With 56 seconds left in the ballgame, and the Cardinals up by 14.
The Cardinals picking up those team fouls now, Steve. There's no stopping those fouls coming now.
And we will see Jermaine Fears for the first time for East Chicago Central as Ezell Moore heads to the bench, and Edwin Underwood, a 6-foot senior, also into the ballgame. Carlton Baker will check out for the last time.
With his work done for the evening, very well, I might say.
17 points. He will lead all scorers. Antoine Fuller is in there for EC Central as well, along with Keon Henderson. So just about a fresh five. Driving through is Davis, trying to take the right, blocked out of there by Powell. Back comes Fuller, dribbled out there, shinned out of bounds. Ball goes back over to Merrillville as the Cardinals reserves try to run the break off the great defensive play by Jacopo Powell, a block off the glass. And the Cardinals fans, doesn't head for the exit. Wilson, off the dribble, a step inside the arc, fires down Hammond, and Eugene Wilson with a couple of free throws coming. So Merrillville will drop to 11-7 on the season. And a situation, Dave, where they've probably seen some things tonight that will help them come tournament time.
Absolutely. We can talk about that on the postgame show.
Yeah, no question about it. But this is not a total lost effort for Merrillville tonight, no question about it. Wilson's free throw is up and good. That gives the Pirates' leading scorer his 10th point of the night. 61-48.
I certainly think there's a lot of good things that Jim needs to see out there from his ball club. Absolutely.
And Wilson will line up the second. It's on the way. Good again. And a stoppage. Eugene Wilson checks out of the basketball game and replaced by Quentin Allen. Durant fears the trigger of the inbound. Gets it into Antoine Bullard. Guarded by Scott Underwood. A stop and go move into the fourth court he goes. Bullard across the timeline with 32. Lots of pass for Fears. Free throw line jumper is up and good. And the 6'2 senior gets to the scorebook for the first time tonight. 63-49. Here's a terrific wide receiver for the Cardinal football team. Here's Davis off the crossover. Drives into a triple team. Lost it. To Underwood for a moment. Taken away by Borup. Bullard the strip. Ahead. Back to an offensive foul as they worked a little give and go with Henderson and Antoine Bullard.